After 60 hours of electrolysis, notice my solutions now, it doesn't show on the camera quite as well, but it's a beautiful emerald green. I love that color. It looks kind of a little yellowish on the camera, but it's actually just a beautiful emerald green. This is not safe for disposal yet. It could still have nickel in it, it still have copper in it, you know, basically metallic salts, clearly. It's got that green color still. And it is rather difficult to get all the metal out with electrolysis. It takes, you know, the rate of deposition is already like significantly decreasing. But at the same time, we did pull out almost 1 troy ounce of copper or metals out of this solution. Out of just 1 12-cup coffee pot, we got you know, almost 1 ounce of metal out of here already, of solid metal. So basically this cup, I mean, the acid is basically regenerated, and not to mention the basically the copper chloride that's in here already is, as I said before, a solvent to dissolve more copper. And basically this 12 cups is capable of dissolving almost 1 ounce more of copper, so it's ready to go. Again, it's a hazardous waste, you can't dispose of it, but what you can do is not have to buy any more hydrochloric acid or make any more of this stuff. You just keep reusing it. Ooh, and we do get some sediment. I'm noticing some sediment in here. So there's some solid sediment down in there. It's interesting. Of course, I have no idea what that is. It could even be gold. But, so I think we will filter that last bit just in case. So I can do that right now. Okay. So, you know, again, we just reuse what we made already for the next batch. Ultimately, when you're done and you're not going to be doing this anymore, what I recommend is to dry this out. I'm going to build a dryer kit and basically reduce it down to the salt crystals, so that all the fluid's gone just by evaporation, basically. And then you know, just reduces the amount of whatever you have to dispose of. And I actually believe, you know, that you could probably send it off to an SA and you know, have those you know, probably find it. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to send off my crystals to have them assayed and figure out, you know, what exactly is in those crystals, and then I can figure out a way to market that after the fact, or what the best way is to dispose of it. But right now, you know, I won't know what's going to be left over until we get to that point. So the next step is going to be the evaporator unit, which I will show how to make and operate.